and you're walking a closer walk with God. God will bless you.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
What kind of situation that you're going through, if you're close with the Almighty God, He will bless you.
Amen.
He will bless you.
Amen.
He will bless you.
Amen.
12 years when I was in Jamaica, God did not put me to shame at all. Not even one day. Because I choose to depend and trust in God.
Hallelujah.
Your circumstances might be bleak. You had a good life in Jamaica. We came here. There are so many struggles. But in all these situations, I will protect you.
Amen.
Because when you have a closer relationship with God, no matter what storm comes, you will have the peace of God this morning.
Amen.
In Isaiah chapter 5, verse 1 to 5, it talks about a beautiful verse. My loved one has a vineyard on a fertile hillside. He dug it up, cleaned it of stones, and planted with choicest vines. He built tower. But what happened? The nation of Israel did not bear fruits, good fruit. He did everything. In verse 7 it says, he looked for justice but saw bloodshed. What type of fruit that you are producing this morning, my dear brothers? God is looking for the fruit of justice.
Yes.
But then you are giving bloodshed. God wants the fruit of righteousness. But you, all you can see is distress. It looks like we have lost the favor of God. God wanted fruit from you. But all he sees is distress. He looks for justice, but all he sees is bloodshed. My dear brethren, let us become more protective. Because one day, many times, it looks like that we are connected to the vine, but we are not bearing fruits. How can we know a tree has life? By its fruit.
Amen.
Just because we come to church. Yes, it's good to come to church. Hallelujah. But are you connected with the vine?
Amen.
Amen.
That is very important.
Amen.
That is very important. See, there were two disciples. One was Peter. The other one was Judas. Both are disciples very close to Jesus for 3.5 years. They walked with Jesus. They talked with Jesus. They ate, had supper with him. Both of them betrayed Jesus. Many times they betrayed Jesus. But one was a pretender. He was a professor of faith. Judas was acting as a man of God. Very close to Jesus, but his eyes was always on the bag. He was a treasurer. His focus was not on Jesus. The question is, we are in the house of God. Is your focus is on Christ?
Amen.
Is your focus is on Christ this morning?
Amen.
That's why both of them betrayed. But one went, had a heart of repentance. The other one went and hanged himself. Many times we are like Peter, but we go back to God. God, forgive me, God. Forgive me, God.
Yes.
For what I have done.
Amen.
For what I have done. God wants you to be a real Christian. A real Christian is a Christian who is protective. Mark chapter 12 verse 28 to 34 it says, in verse 33, you know the story. To love with all your heart, with all your understanding, with all your strength, love your neighbor as yourself is more important than all burnt offerings and sacrifices. Verse 34, Jesus said, He said, when Jesus saw that he had answered wisely, he said to him, "You are not far away from the kingdom of God." He's talking to this man and he's telling, "You are not far away from the kingdom of God." This morning, God is asking you, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ, how close you are to the kingdom of God. If you want to be productive, the question is how close you are to the kingdom of God. You cannot stand at the fringes, at the edge, and ask for God's blessings. The woman said, the Syrophoenician woman said, even if you throw the bread that falls, or the crumbs that falls from the table, I'm willing to submit myself as a slave. I'm willing to submit worse than a dog. All I need is a breakthrough. All I need is a fruit girl.
Thank you, Lord.
You might be a great man of God or a woman of God, but God is looking how humble you are when you throw at the presence of the Almighty God. God is there to see your humility and reward your patience.
Amen.
There were two thieves on the cross. Both were standing between the vine, the mercy tree. But one was connected with the vine, the other was not connected. Both were near, but one was connected, the other was disconnected. And he was fruitful. The Bible says, today you will be in paradise.
Yes.
What a protective life. All these years, he was a scoundrel. He was a wicked man. He was a thief. But Jesus said, today you will be in paradise. What a privilege, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ.
Thank you, Lord.
Closeness to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Closer walk with God will bring fruitful. You'll be fruitful. Secondly, how can I be fruitful? Fruitfulness comes from the Holy Spirit.
Yes,
hallelujah!
Amen.
Fruitfulness comes from the Holy Spirit because the scripture says, what will the Holy Spirit do to your life? Verse number 2, it says, John chapter 15 verse 2 says, he proves. Then it says, he cleanses. The vine tree has to be pruned. What is pruning? Many of you know gardening. What is pruning? Pruning is cutting the dead buds, shoots, sometimes the living tissues, so that the vine tree bears more fruit. Why do we do pruning? Because it increases the size of the fruit. It increases the sugar content. It decreases the disease problem. It increases the vitamins that it has. In our life too, God prunes certain situations. In Colossians chapter 2 verse 12 says, in him you were also circumcised in putting off the sinful nature, not with the circumcision done by the hands of men, but with the circumcision by heart. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, sometimes God allows certain circumstances in our lives. Some death situations, some unwanted relationships.
Yes.
He cuts that off. It might be hurtful. It might be painful. It might be insidious. But the reason is for God to cut those, to prune those things. nations. But the Holy Spirit tells you, I have done that because I want to bless you.
Amen.
I removed that situation. I removed you from that job. I removed you from that relationship because I kept something new. I kept something far better. Thank God for the pruning.
Amen.
Thank God for the cleansing.
Amen.
Thank God for the pruning. It might be hurtful. It might be painful. You might ask God, God, are you there? I'm going through this. I'm going through this situation. I do not have money to pay for my university. In this, what God, are you happy about my situation, my dear daughter, my dear son? You are crying over the situation. But I serve an almighty God.
Amen.
I serve an almighty God.
Hallelujah.
He knows far better than you.
Amen.
He keeps your future in his palms. You do not know what your future is for. But God knows your future. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So every trial that you go through, every suffering that you go through is for a purpose.
Amen.
The reason is because, why does he does this pruning? He wants the image of his son formed in us. Every time he cuts, every time he prunes, every time he cleanses, the more he cleanses, the more he prunes, is because the nature of his son Christ is embedded in our lives. The very character of God, the very nature of God is in our life. When people say, oh, this must be a man of God, the way he walked, the way he talked, he's very protective, he's fruitful, because when you go through this pruning, you know, if you go to Disneyland, they try to shape the trees or the grass into some rabbit, into Mickey Mouse. Have you seen that? So every time God is trimming something in your life, it's so that he's shaping something in your life.
Amen. Hallelujah.
It might be painful.
Yep.
When a man who came to Jesus who was blind, what did Jesus do? He took some mud and spit on it, and he was rubbing on his face. That was painful. That was dirty. How can the master do such an insidious act? When God touches our life, you do not like that. But as he was touching the blind man's eye, he was creating something new.
Yes, amen.
Every time God touches you, it is painful. But at the end, there is something new coming out.
Amen.
There is something protective coming out. There is some fruit coming out this morning, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ. He will put an end to it here. So thank God for this pruning situation. Thank God for his cleansing blood. In Hebrews chapter 13, verse 21. In Hebrews chapter 13, verse 21, it says, Christ equip you with everything good for doing his will, and he may work in us what is pleasing to him. God will equip you. You say, I do not have money, but I have the talent. You say, I do not have the opportunity, but the scriptures say, yes, Christ equips you. That means Christ prospers you. He makes you successful. Whatever you do. In 2 Corinthians chapter 9 verse 8 says, and God is able to make all grace abound to you, so that in all things, at all times, having all that you need, you will abound in every good works. Oh, what a wonderful God we have. Thank God for the grace, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ, for you to be successful, for you to be prosperous, for you to be fruitful, for you to be productive. You need the grace of God.
Amen.
The more the grace, the more the protective you are. So do not worry. God, at the right time, he will send the right person in your life. a right connection, a right resource, and then everything will be okay.
Amen.
Our church needs $100,000. And pastor said one good statement, one check is enough. God can send one person into connection.
Yes.
And change the situation.
Amen.
All this I'm telling again and again, God wants us to be protective and fruitful.
Yes.
In Hebrews chapter 12 verse 11 it says, no discipline seems pleasant at the time, but it's painful. But however it produces a harvest of righteousness and peace and for those who have been trained by it. If you want to be productive, you have to go through discipline.
Yeah.
Strict regiment. If you are an army man, you know.